Southeast Asia Director of ITDP, and today I will share the introduction of electric buses in the Transjakarta system. I will start with the electrification project under ITDP Indonesia and things that prompted the introduction of e-bus in Indonesia, mainly in Jakarta. Then I will explain more about Transjakarta electrification plan and current progress, benefit, barrier, challenges, and also key takeaways. ITDP Indonesia has supported sustainable mobility development in Indonesia since 1999. Globally, ITDP operates in 7 countries, consistently promotes and give recommendation and technical assistance to the development of bus rapid transit, including its electrification, non-motorized transport, transit-oriented development, transport demand management, and also sustainable urban design. ITDP Indonesia began to support e-mobility transitions in the country since 2020 through the project under UNEP CTCN for supporting Jakarta's transition to e-mobility, which focuses on the development of roadmap and timetable for BRT and non-BRT services of Transjakarta. As of now, we have 6 technical assistance projects in 3 cities in Indonesia, including a nationwide project. Outside Jakarta, the national government has already set an initiative to develop e-mobility for public transportation under the by the service or BTS scheme by the Ministry of Transportation. The government targets to electrify 90% of public transportation fleets in 34 provinces by 2030. Jakarta was ranked among the most polluted major cities in the world. Even though buses in Jakarta only account for a small amount of mode proportion compared to other vehicles, based on 2080 calculations, it contributed to nearly half of the CO2 emissions and more than 20% of air pollution emission in the city, highest among all transportation modes. In the local level, the government of Jakarta pledged their commitment to create an inclusive climate action plan, joining other 34 cities around the world under Fossil Fuel Free Street Initiative by C40 Cities. The city commit to only procure zero emission buses started in 2025 and ensure the majority of area is emission free by 2030. The government is affirmed through Government Regulation Number 19/2021 on Low Carbon Regional Development Plan. Transjakarta, a bus rapid transit system in Jakarta, is the longest BRT corridor in the world. The corridor spans more than 250 kilometers and has 248 BRT stations. Outside the BRT service, Transjakarta has 7 types of services. A border service that connects suburban area to the city center, direct service, microbus, Royal Trans, tourism, and affordable housing services. With the support of the third-party operators, until 2020, Transjakarta has operated more than 4,000 units of buses. There are articulated buses, maxi, single, mini trans, and micro trans. Transjakarta also set a target to regularly phase out the diesel buses and procure around 10,000 electric fleets by 2030. With those figures, more than 80% of Transjakarta fleets will be electric. The electrification started by the single and low entry bus in 2022. By 2030, the majority of electric buses will be from Transjakarta Microtrans, followed by low entry buses that as of now serve non-BRT routes. Transjakarta has a three-phase implementation to ensure fleet eligibility and also reliability. To set on the seal for the APM and operator readiness. The first phase, pre-trial, was conducted in 3 months to ensure the completeness of the vehicle legality, actual battery consumption in the field, and conformity to the needs of Transjakarta. After the pre-trial phase, the pilot phase is now carried out for 2 years under the gross cost contract. The contract period is based on the lifetime of the e-bus. After the end of year 2, a review of the maintenance and operation costs will be conducted. After the pilot ends, contract with operator is continued under the full implementation phase with adjusted maintenance and operation costs. At the first phase, operator should have finished preparing all infrastructure needed and being certified to operate and maintain e-bus complying with Transjakarta electrification. Transjakarta has several considerations for selecting the most suitable pilot routes. The number of buses, percentage TCO different between ICE and e-bus, daily passenger per bus, and route feasibility. The pilot route would not be deployed in one route only, but several routes will be selected at the same time for the initial pilot phase to spread the possible operational risk. 30 fleets will be operated in 4 non-BRT routes. These routes have very high visibility because it passes through the CBD area in the city. As of now, 4 fleets are currently operating in Route 1P. Transjakarta large-scale electrification efforts only affect a very small percentage of additional electricity demand. It could lead to 26% reduction on operational costs in a 5-year contract period and 30% reduction of CO2 in 2030. It will also lead to positive impact on equality and accessibility, including low-income and vulnerable group, ensuring no one left behind. Even though Transjakarta has successfully started the e-bus pilot phase, the implementation itself faced several barriers and challenges, such as lack of supporting local policy from the government, higher complexity of electrification, and business model that cannot cope with high initial investment. Furthermore, for the pilot route itself, the bus has a high dead kilometer due to overnight charging infrastructure locations, which is far from the road operation. And to conclude, ITDP has pointed out 8 key points to accelerate Transjakarta electrification and make the electrification more impactful. First, transform the existing business model. Second, extend electric bus contract duration. And next is accelerate charging infrastructure provision and adopt renewable energy for charging. On the other side, Transjakarta should ensure the readiness of information technology service, including integrating battery management system into the current systems. and accommodate vulnerable groups need to ensure no one is left behind on the electrification. Since the technology is not mature enough in Indonesia, knowledge transfer about electric buses operation and maintenance is compulsory. The last, since the electrification is an interdepartmental effort, an interdepartmental electrification empowered group such as e-mobility task force is heavily needed. I think that's all that I can share about electrification, mainly for Transjakarta. Thank you.